New order, I ask all present to please rise and join with me as we recite the Pledge of Allegiance to our flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In the absence of clergy, I ask all to bow their heads in a moment of silent reflection.
Reading of the journal.
The Senate Sunday, January 22nd, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Saturday, January 21, was read and approved on motion. Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions, messages from the Assembly, messages from the Governor, reports of standing committees, reports of select committees, motions, communications, and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator LaValle.
Mr. President, may we please have the non-controversial reading of the calendar at this time.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 4 by Senator Marcellino, Center Print 950, enact amend the real property tax law.
Last section.
Section 2 of this act shall take effect immediately.
Call roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 43.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 6 by Senator Ranzenhofer, Senate Print 3188, enact amend the alcoholic beverage control law.
Last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 44.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 21 by Senator Maziar, Senate Print 164C, enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 45, nays 1. Senator Rivera recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 23 by Senator DeLon, Senate Print 1362, enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Last section.
Section 2, this act should take effect on the 30th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 45, nays 1. Senator Duane recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 26 by Senator Fuchillo, Senate Print 3452, enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect on the 1st of November.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 50.
The bill is passed.
In relation to calendar 26, ayes 49, nays 1, Senator Ball recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 27 by Senator Fuchillo, Senate Print 5171B, enact amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act should take effect on the 90th day.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 49, nays 1. Senator Adams recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 28 by Senator Fuchillo, Senate Print 5870, enact amend the public authorities law.
Last section.
Section 5, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin.
Adams.
Ayes 48, nays 2. Senator Adams and Duane recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 29 by Senator Young, Senate Print 794, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 49, nays 1. Senator Duane recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 30 by Senator Grisanti, Senate Print 2648, enact amend the environmental conservation law.
Last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call roll.
Adams, D. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. In relation to calendar 30, those recorded in the negative are Senators DeLon, Duane, Espaillat, and Perkins. Ayes 4... In relation to calendar number 30, those recorded in the negative are Senators Dwayne, Espaillat, Perkins, and Serrano. Ayes 46, nays 4.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 32 by Senator Hannan, Senate Print 4376B, enact amend the public health law.
Last section.
Section 6, this act shall take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Adam C. Francisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 52.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 33 by Senator Nozzolio, Senate Print 4665, enact amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin. Ayes 51, nays 1. Senator Avella recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 34 by Senator Young, Senate Print 5210, enact amend the public health law.
Last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adams, DeFrancisco, Libous, Sampson, Skelos, Zeldin.
Senator Dwayne to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just want to note my strong agreement with this piece of legislation, and it's important, particularly in rural areas around our state, and I look forward to a time when we can fund adding dental as one of the services that we bring to the entire state. And I hope to continue to work with Senator Young on this issue to make it a reality in our state. Thank you, Mr. President. I vote aye.
Senator Dwayne to be recorded in the affirmative. Is there any other senator wishing to explain their vote? Announce the results.
Ayes 51, nays 1. In relation to rule number 9, Senator DeFrancisco recorded in the negative.
The bill is passed. Senator Lavelle, that completes the reading of the non-controversial calendar.
Is there any other business at the desk?
There is a resolution, Senator Lavelle.
Yeah, Mr. President, with unanimous consent, I'd like to recognize Senator Espaillat for a brief announcement.
Without objection, Senator Espaillat, you are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you for allowing me to introduce a group that has been coming to the New York State Legislature since February of 1997. They are the Instituto Duartiano. They celebrate the anniversary of the birth of Juan Pablo Duarte, the founding father of the Dominican Republic, who was born the 26th of January of 1813. There's a big delegation this year headed by the president of the Institute, Mr. Juan Elliott, and representatives from the Council, the Dominican Republic Council General's office. The Council General, Mr. Ramon Corsino, could not be here today, but he sent Isabel Padilla, who is head of the delegation, along with Cecilia Baez, who are both in the balcony, and they're celebrating, they're kicking off Juan Pablo Duarte Week, and it has been a tradition of this group to visit both the Assembly and the Senate and visit the proceedings. So I thank you, Mr. President, for allowing me to introduce them and to make sure that the entire Senate understands what they're about. They're about the legacy of Juan Pablo Duarte, particularly for young children, teaching them who he was, and they're doing a fantastic job. So thank you for allowing them to visit the Senate chambers.
Senator Vera, do you want to?
I also stand to welcome our guest today to the Senate chamber. And there's a couple of reasons why I do that. And the most important one is because I represent about 100,000 Dominicans in my district. Many of them have actually crossed over from Washington Heights, Quisqueya Heights, if you will, where many have lived for generations. And increasingly I find that there's many of these folks that are in my backyard. They are my allies locally. In here in the Senate, I obviously have two great colleagues in Adriano Espaillat and Jose Peralta, which are both Dominican. And I would be remiss if I did not mention my colleague in the Assembly, Nelson Castro, who crosses over with me in the district. This is a community that is a rich community. It is a community that is rich with culture. They are a zesty community. They enjoy participating in politics. To them, it is a full contact sport. And I enjoy having them as my colleagues here in the Senate, colleagues in the Assembly, but most importantly, as people that are represented in my district. Thank you again for coming to Bienvenidos al Senado Estatal. And I hope that all of my colleagues take some time to also welcome them as well. Thank you, Mr. President.
I will continue to acknowledge speakers without objection. Senator Perkins.
Bienvenidos. Soy el senador de la comunidad dominicana. ¿Me entiende? Gracias. It's a great pleasure that I have to serve as a senator that represents part of the Dominican community. As a community, I've had the privilege of working with them for many, many years. Long before he was a great state senator, I remember working with Senator Espaillat when he actually was a candidate for a very local position as a member of the community school board. It was a very historic period because then, in our recognition of the value of immigrants and the value of parents, we allowed them to vote in school board elections. And he was a great organizer of the Dominican community in Manhattan to get them out to participate in the electoral process. And now they have become a political giant, not only in Manhattan, but in the whole city of New York. And so I want to thank you for the privilege of being here with you and the opportunity to work with your brother from the Dominican Republic. Welcome.
Senator Diaz.
Thank you, Mr. President. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, every country has their heroes and heroines, and most of them have specific days in which to honor their heroes. For example, Africa honors Nelson Mandela, America honors George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, Martin Luther King, and many others. Puerto Rico honors Don Luis Muñoz Marín and Don Pedro Albizu Campos, among others. The Dominican Republic honors the birth of Juan Pablo Duarte Díez, born on July 26, 1813, and who died on July 15, 1876. In his 63 years of life, Juan Pablo Duarte y Díez left a legacy of pride, courage, and honor for all Dominicans to celebrate. Together with Don Francisco de Rosario and Ramón Matías Mella, Juan Pablo Duarte y Díez was a visionary who is widely considered as the architect of the Dominican Republic and its independence from Haiti in 1844. That is why, Mr. President and ladies and gentlemen, today I'm proud to honor my colleague and friend and brother, Adriano Espaillat, in congratulating the people of the Dominican Republic on this occasion and supporting this wonderful resolution declaring January 23rd Juan Pablo Duarte Day in the state of New York. To Mr. Juan Elliott, president of the Instituto Duartiano, and the delegation from New York City that are here visiting us today, congratulations, and thank you all for honoring us with your presence. And to you, Quisqueyano valientes alcemos, nuestro lento condena emoción. Hey, Dios los bendiga. Muchas gracias.
A new vocalist. Is there any other senator that wishes to be heard? We want to welcome our guests and thank you for being with us today. Senator LaValle.
Mr. President, there being no further business, I move we adjourn till Tuesday, January 24th at 11 a.m.
There is no further business upon motion. The Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, January 24th at 11 a.m.